The Gulf oil disaster is the worst spill in American history. You know, when we think of oil spills, we all harken back to Exxon Valdez and those images of oiled birds and the black crude that came up onto the shore. This oil spill is different. It surpasses the Exxon spill in terms of total volume of oil put into the environment by a lot, and it's still ongoing, so we don't know how big it will actually be. The oil is coming in at very deep water, 5,000 feet of water. So most of the oil actually remains below the surface of the water. Oil spill responders are concerned primarily with the coast because it's where we live. It's what we can see. And the Gulf of Mexico is ringed with 60% of the coastal wetlands in the United States. So the government and BP have been relying heavily on dispersants to break the oil up offshore and dilute it into a large volume of water. Chemical dispersants are applied to help break up the oil into tiny droplets, like soap, dish soap. But the choice of using dispersants is a trade-off. By keeping the oil offshore, they're directing it to other ecosystems. And in this case, the ecosystem of the open ocean, and also the ecosystems on the bottom of the ocean. There have been observations of large plumes of oil, 10 miles long, as deep as 1,300 feet, drifting through the water. Anything that encounters those oil plumes will be harmed. For example, a whale shark, which is a filter feeder, is likely to get its gills coated with this oil and die. If the plumes of oil contact the bottom, they'll cause harm to some of the complex and beautiful bottom habitat of the Gulf. Ultimately, what impact this oil has a lot to do with where it goes. If it stays as an oil slick, it's going to affect creatures that exist on the surface of the oil, the dolphins that come up to breathe, the birds that dive to fish. Those creatures will get either poisoned or smothered with oil, and they'll probably die. If the oil is dispersed into the upper part of the water column, it will encounter the highest concentration of life in the ocean. The upper layer of the water column is where the light penetrates and where the plants grow. It's where the zooplankton graze and the fish eat the zooplankton. So it's that kind of essential food chain of the open ocean that will be contaminated. One thing fisheries biologists are really concerned about is that many fish spawned in the Gulf of Mexico in the spring, right when this oil spill started. Every April, the entire Western Atlantic bluefin population migrates to the Gulf of Mexico right near the oil spill, and they reproduce. All of those larvae are floating around the upper layer of water right where the oil is and will likely die. How much harm is done to the Gulf of Mexico's ecosystems will be determined partly by how healthy those ecosystems are. And unfortunately, we're already dealing with a damaged ecosystem. Many of the fish populations are overfished. Much of the coastal marshes are already degraded from development. So the impacts of this oil spill are going to be much larger than they would have been in a healthy system. NRDC is working on a national ocean policy. This would be analogous to the Clean Air Act for air or the Clean Water Act for water, and it would prioritize ocean health. Right now, the ultimate harm of this oil spill is not known. It's going to require study in the open ocean, at the bottom of the ocean, and on the coasts. But it's clear that wherever the oil goes, it's going to cause harm.